But then there is another reason why Kairouan is so, so important.
Marisa, how did we end up here?
I don't know.
For those who have visited Italy, specifically Sicily, there's a lot in common.
This is it.
So amazing. Such artists.
This is my biggest dream coming true. It's unbelievable. Here we are from the Luage station in Sousse. We're gonna get a personal Luage here with some friendly Tunisians on board. You see? Okay. We're going to Kairouan today. Navigating the system here is just insane. Insane. There's so many ticket stations. They're now throwing us on this Luage here. Oh, I guess we're the first ones. So a Luage basically is a kind of like a taxi. It's a minivan. 8 places, you get your ticket, you just wait for it to fill it up, and then you go to your destination. That's pretty much it. It's a very cheap way to travel around Tunisia if you're not with an organized tour. And yeah, today we're gonna go to Kairouan.
So how much did our tickets cost?
6 dinar, so 2 euros each.
Okay, so 2 euros each, and we have
at least an hour.
A car ride that's about an hour.
Yeah.
It's probably over 90 degrees. And
it's gonna get worse.
It's gonna get hotter. And we're sitting in a car off with no AC. That's okay. In the distance over there, you can see the public toilets, which I use. Leave that for another day. And yeah, so now it's just a waiting game.
Yeah.
The Luage is full. So we are off. We only had to wait like a few minutes. Perfect.
Bye-bye.
Shukran.
So Marisa, not too bad after all.
No.
Not a bad ride.
No. Okay, here we are. We literally jumped out of the Luage in a second. One of the funny things about the Luage is that, like, once you arrive at your destination, if it's not the Luage station, you jump out and just slam the door and they just go.
Yeah.
You know, no, like, have a nice day, no, just
nothing.
Boom.
We just arrived in the city of Kairouan, right outside the Great Mosque. The reason why we're here, there's several reasons actually. It's because Kairouan is a very, very important city for the history of Tunisia, both political and religious. We're gonna tell you all about it.
It is hot. That is one thing I'll say.
It's hot. It's more than 30 degrees Celsius. So for you guys,
it's probably close to 100 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah, 90 something.
But as they always love to say, it's hot but not humid.
Wa alaikum salam.
Wait. Where do you come from?
Sousse.
Tunisia?
No, Italian.
Italian. Quelle ville de l'Italie?
Naples.
Scarafu, Uni, Scarafu.
Pino Daniele.
Balla mamma so.
Wow.
Oh my God, the Pino Daniele in Tunisia.
No.
This is my biggest dream coming true. It's unbelievable.
Ma io la ex mia moglie italiana, fratello, hai capito? Però sono nato qui. Questo è il santuario, il mio bisnonno, però non a Napoli, abitavo a Padova.
Padova?
Ah, Padova, più nord.
Più a nord.
L'Adriatico. Ma è una vita che vado su e giù. Adesso 7 anni non vado perché mi hanno rotto il coglione là.
Sì, basta. Pure a me ha rotto il coglione.
There's all these really beautiful rugs over here. As usual, the problem is even as much as I would love to buy one, when you're traveling just with this a backpack, that makes
how are you going to transport
impossible.
That? Exactly. I'm sure you have. It's beautiful. Thank you. So the importance of Kairouan. The reason why this city is so important, at least in the history of Tunisia, is that this city was the ancient capital of Tunisia. So the city was in a very strategic position, and for that reason, it remained the capital of Tunisia for many, many centuries, until Tunis became the new capital and the current capital of Tunisia. But then there is another reason why Kairouan is so, so important in Tunisia and in the Islamic world. And it's because it's considered to be the fourth holiest city for Muslims. After Mecca, Medina, Jerusalem, there is finally Kairouan. The reason why Kairouan is the fourth holiest city for Muslims, it's because you can do 7 pilgrimages to Kairouan if you're a Muslim, and those count as 1 pilgrimage to Mecca.
So if you like can't afford maybe the trip to Mecca, you can take 7.
It's a very expensive trip.
Yeah, you can take 7 pilgrimages here
to Kairouan.
To Kairouan.
A trip to Mecca, not only it's very expensive, but it's basically impossible to afford for most people in Arab countries or in Islamic countries, where they literally live day by day and they have no way to save money to do a trip that, according to the religion, has to be done at least once in their lifetime. So for locals here in Tunisia, you can come to Kairouan as a pilgrim 7 times. That counts as 1 trip to Mecca.
And that counts as sufficient.
Yep.
Grazie mille. You can now choose your headscarf for the visit of the mosque.
I don't know if I want purple?
Really beautiful colors.
Or blue. Maybe purple. Purple. Really beautiful.
Okay. It does match the outfit. Ooh, look at that. Okay.
Maybe this one isn't going to see him. Okay.
Ready? Let's go. Maybe, yeah, the sunglasses.
A little toasty under here.
It is toasty.
This is the inside, the courtyard of the mosque. It's truly, truly beautiful. It is worth a visit. Unfortunately, we're not allowed as non-Muslims to enter the prayer chamber. We can see them from outside, so I'm gonna take a quick video. You can feel it's a completely different climate in here. It's so fresh. So no matter the time of the year, praying inside this room, you just feel good.
It's almost like there's air conditioning.
It's the stones that make it so fresh. It's like going into a church. It's the same kind of a freshness that you get. The architecture is really impressive, and for those who have visited Italy, specifically Sicily, there's a lot in common, a lot in common. I mean, Sicily was under control from the Arabs for centuries, and I mean, the influence survived mostly in the architecture, even in the language. Sometimes between Sicilian and Arabic, there's a lot in common. But this could literally be somewhere in Palermo. These are all classical styles. Some of them remind you of Greek columns, some others Roman columns. And then obviously there is the influence of the Byzantine architecture. There's so much, so many mixes.
Overlaps
over the centuries. They resulted in this.
Let's go see what this structure is.
I'm gonna say it might reference to the direction for Mecca. I'm not sure, but I think that's probably what it is, because it's way too random. I mean, look at what it is. It's placed in the middle of, you know, the square, let's say, the main area, and it's just facing a specific direction, it has to be for that. To those who have never been inside a mosque or they don't really know much about Islam, one thing you will notice when you enter inside a mosque is that there's no statues, there's no paintings, there's no reference to all the figures, all the prophets or God. Because according to Islam, you're not allowed to represent God, you're not allowed to even represent Muhammad, the prophet, or the other prophets that they believe in, like Abraham and Jesus. Which obviously can be a little bit of a difference with churches, for example,
right.
But also a very interesting cultural difference that I like to notice, to observe. Let's keep exploring Kairouan. Let's go.
What's going on in here, Marisa? Assalamu alaikum. Labes. Labes. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. What is this, Marisa?
It looks like a giant loom.
Like very traditional. Watching some TV. So he has to pedal to work.
Thank you.
Bye.
So amazing. Such artists. And he's doing that all with that machine, but there's like no electricity or new.
Just the pure strength of his muscles.
Yeah.
So we're gonna go now and try and see a mausoleum, another special type of building that you can find in this part of the world.
Let's go see.
Ah, il a mausoleum.
Ah, ok.
Vous êtes équipé?
Oui, oui.
Entrez. Hein. Ça, c'est très vrai.
Ouh. The tile work here is always just the coolest thing. The colors, the designs, and just the fact that it's everywhere. It's just like, oh my god.
Assalamu alaikum.
So our visit to this mausoleum so far has been confusing.
All the doors are opened, but you're not allowed to enter any door. This one here, yes, but...
It's very ambiguous.
Yeah. What we've learned, this place here, this mausoleum, was built to be kind of like a cultural site, a place where people would come and learn.
We were reading that in addition to people coming here to pray, they also had knowledge parties, which is really fun, where they would talk about, you know, all different things to just learn about the world.
People would gather here around a scholar, around a teacher, a person that would be either sitting or, you know, right in the yard or in one of the rooms, and all the students would be around learning whatever topic that day the teacher decided was going to teach. No schedule, no syllabus, no, you know, you just go and the teacher is going to teach you something worth knowing, and yeah, you're just going to learn. In a way, as you said, it's kind of like Così parlò Bella Vista, a book by a Neapolitan writer that wrote about this specific situation happening in Napoli with a professor gathering all the people from the neighborhood at his home and teaching them about Neapolitan philosophy.
Yes.
That's it.
Assalamu alaikum. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Leves. Alhamdulillah. Leves. Leves. Jnou fil hanout. Jnou hada
hanout. Sami3at el ala el mousiqiya.
On a dit un lutaio.
Lutier.
He's a lutaio. I don't know in English, but he makes instruments.
Wow.
Oh my god.
What instruments?
I don't know.
Chouf. Chouf.
Traditionnel, no? Traditionnel tunisien.
Ah, voilà, ecco qua, quello è uno.
Ah, look, there's violins up there. A guitar. We must be like in a neighborhood where there's like artisans everywhere. We the loom instruments.
Liutaio. Andy sahbi f'Italia huwa liutaio. Luthier. Pour guitar. Voilà, voilà, voilà. Luca.
Yes.
Luca, wow, incroyable. Je veux lui montrer
le vidéo qu'il y a en liutaio.
Oui, oui, Sabek,
voilà, mio amico.
Sabek, regardez
la Tunis. Wow, this is incredible, I love it. Handmade.
Wow.
Luciano Pavarotti.
Ça, c'est chanteuse juif.
Ah, ça c'est juif.
Ça
c'est juif.
Juif, mais il est Murat.
Ah, Murat.
So Jewish.
Ah.
This artist and then Lebanese, a lot of Egyptian artists.
Because Egypt is kind of like the Hollywood of the Arab world. They make a lot of movies, music. Il y a des instruments que vous avez faits
oui, oui.
Que les gens ont utilisés par la musique,
musique
en Tunisie.
Mes amis et moi, des musiciens.
Ok.
Ah, voilà.
C'est moi.
Ah,
oui.
Musicien.
Musicien, oui.
So he's also a player.
Ah, okay.
A violin player.
Wow.
Ça, c'est vous?
That's you.
Ah,
c'est moi.
Ok. Et wow, c'est, très c'est élégant.
Des chanteuses, ça. De chanteuse
de la Tunisie.
Oui,
intéressant.
Oh. Merci.
Shukran Barsha.
Bonne
journée.
Bonne
journée.
Ça, c'est le Barnouz.
Barnouz. Ça,
Kairouan.
Ça, c'est le kashabia.
Ah, le kashabia. Et ça ici, sont pour les hommes.
Pour les hommes.
Pour
oui.
Les hommes.
Pour savoir. Kadash, Wahad.
Ça.
Pour les Tunisiens.
Oui, pour les Tunisiens. Mia Othmani.
180 dinars for a Tunisian to buy these. So more or less 60. Right? Yeah, it's 60 euros. It's really, really warm.
For winter, it's
perfect. For winter, it's perfect. You know, because you gotta be warm. If you go to pray to the mosque, you gotta be warm.
Mm-hmm.
Ça, la broderie avec les mains.
So all these decorations, they're handmade.
Avec les mains. Ça, avec la machine.
Okay.
Because
this one here has like a few things that are made with a machine, so that's why they're slightly cheaper. Trop chaud. Trop chaud. La prochaine fois en hiver, je veux ça. Shukran.
Merci.
I kind of wish it wasn't this hot, and maybe that it was colder. I would have definitely bought that. That was the warmest. I don't want to say coat, I don't want to say hoodie, just it was so warm, you know, it would have been perfect for the winter.
We can probably use it in Boston, Connecticut, or New York.
Oh my God, it would have been
perfect.
Also, I found it so funny how the other guy, the one that was sitting, kept telling him things in Arabic, which he was basically trying to say, sell him one. And the other guy was saying, no, I just want to describe first. Then he asked me if I wanted to buy, but you know, traveling with just a backpack, it's hard to buy things.
Marisa, how did we end up here?
I don't know.
I have no idea. What is this place? The house of the governor of Kairouan.
Seems like a shop.
English.
Seems like a shop to me.
Seems like the old governor's house that they turn into a shop, probably. that they're gonna try and sell us stuff. So we just learned that the governor had four wives. It's a lot of work, a lot of work.
It's really beautiful, really, really beautiful.
Wow.
The House of Souks.
I don't even know what to say because it is such a beautiful palace. I never would imagine that the governor. We would have seen this on this trip when we were researching what to see in Kairouan. This was not one of the things we had in mind. I mean, a beautiful surprise, definitely worth checking it out, even though it looks like a shop. And I still think it's probably a shop, but worth the visit. The roofs of Kairouan, probably the hottest weather in the universe right now. It's close to 36, 37 degrees. Just as a reminder, it's almost the end of October, okay? I know it's North Africa, but still, wow.
That's why I'm hiding in the shade.
Yeah, of course. That's why we gotta end the visit to this place by filming here in this, you know, in this position. Marissa, we made it all the way to the Tunisia's gate, one of the main doors that surround the city, the ancient city of Kairouan. It's been an incredible exploration. As usual, when you explore these towns, you go for the sightseeing, you go to see museums, mosques, ancient buildings, obviously, but you always gotta find time to stop and talk to locals, ask questions, see what they're doing, see what their lives look like, and even if just for a few minutes, there's always something that you can learn about them.
What's really fun and interesting too is that, you know, you see people, you think they're busy, they're working, you don't want to interrupt them, but then you just say a quick, you know, assalamu alaikum, say how beautiful, and then they immediately smile, want to talk to you, share their craft, and that's something that really struck me about this place today.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Kairouan. And beautiful Tunisia.
Assalamu alaikum.
And to end the day, back on the Louage. This back time the other way around to Sousse. We gotta say this station, much more calm.
Yes.
And organized. Just one ticket booth. Well, actually, three. But you know, all together. While in Sousse, there's like seven different stops.
And Davide did a good job. He had to read it in Arabic, and he did it.